I am going to show you the most romantic shape in mathematics, and it's this, the Möbius loop. To make a Möbius loop, you start with a strip of paper, which is why it's often called a Möbius strip. You take a piece of tape, you apply that to one end of the piece of paper. You then go to stick the two ends together, but don't stick them together like this. This is a boring cylinder. We can do so much better. Before you join the ends, you take one of them off, you turn them over, and you stick them together so there is now a twist in that loop. And this twisted piece of paper is known as a Möbius loop. And the first person to investigate the mathematics behind this twisted shape was in the 1800s. It was a guy called Mr. Möbius, and he was so proud of this shape that he named himself after it. For our romantic maths, arts and craft project, we actually need two Möbius loops. And the easiest way to do that, you can see I've used paper which is reasonably wide. I can make a little snip in the center there. Now I can take my scissors and I can very carefully cut all the way around, right down the center. And when I get back to where I started, I will have two Möbius loops that are both exactly the... What? You can't cut a Möbius loop in half. If you cut right down the center, you end up with this. It's another complete loop of paper, only now, instead of having one twist, after we've cut down the center, this piece of paper has four twists. If we now cut this in half, we would get something different again. For every different number of twists you start with, if you cut that twisted loop of paper in half, you will get a different result. And some fantastic patterns start to emerge where what you end up with is based on the number of twists you started with. But that is a different project for a different time. We are going to move on to sticking more than one loop together before we cut them in half. And that changes everything. Here I have a standard issue zero twist cylinder, and these are incredibly boring because if you cut them right down the center, you get exactly what you expect, two zero twist cylinders. But if we stick them together, it changes completely. Here I have another zero twist cylinder with some tape on it. I'm going to stick it to the first one so that they are at right angles to each other. So one of them goes that way, one goes that way. It's two perpendicular loops of paper. I'm going to put some more tape on the back. If you do try this yourself afterwards, and believe me, a lot of you will, make sure you use plenty of tape, because if you're not careful, when you cut both these loops together, it will accidentally come undone in the wrong places. Okay, so I'm making a snip in the first of the two zero twist loops. I'm cutting all the way down the center of it, right through where it joins the other one, out the other side, back to where I started, and I get, okay, that. I'm now gonna cut down the center of the other one, right back to where I started, and two loops stuck together at right angles, both cut in half, give you a square. Check it out, it gives you a square. I did not see that coming. The first time I cut two loops in half while they were stuck together orthogonally, I was amazed. This blew my tiny mind, and I'm sure for a lot of you, when you saw me do this just then, you were as astounded as I was. The only problem is, some of you watching this will have other people in the room with you. Maybe they looked over your shoulder to see what was so interesting and amusing about a mathematics video on YouTube, and for a few people, some would have looked around right as I was going, "Hey everybody, a square!" And you were like, "Whoa, a square!" And the person behind you is like, "Wow, there's some pretty advanced maths in this video. Oh my goodness, a square! Wait till you guys see a triangle. Woo!" On to the main event. Two Möbius loops stuck together at right angles. I am now going to cut both of these in half at the same time. So I snip the first one, cut all the way down the center. And just like before, I'm not going to succeed in cutting it in half. I'm going to get one new loop, but this time it's going to have bits of the other one still attached to it. So I cut down the center of the second loop. I'm being very careful to not accidentally cut through the wrong bit of paper as I go. And I end up with, now this will take a moment to untangle, I end up with, it's two hearts that go through each other. Look at that! Two Möbius loops stuck together, both cut in half, give you a linked pair of hearts. And you now know what I'm giving my wife for Valentine's Day. Two Möbius loops and a pair of scissors. and instructions. Before you try the interlinked maths hearts, there's one thing you need to bear in mind, one slight knack. When you make your Möbius loop, you're actually faced with a choice, because you could turn the paper over and twist it to the right, or you could twist it to the left, and you get different Möbius loops depending on which way you twist it. A right-handed Möbius loop is a mirror image with a left-handed Möbius loop. We say they have different chirality. They twist in different directions. And for the two hearts to work, you need to have a right-handed with a left-handed. If you have two Möbius loops of the same direction twist, when you cut them in half, you won't get two hearts. You get like a boat and a thing. They're not even linked together. It is a world of disappointment. There you have it, the most romantic shape in mathematics. Thank you very much for watching the video. If you yourself heart mathematics, be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I hugely appreciate the support, and there'll be loads of more interesting bits of maths coming up. If you want to learn more about the topology of Möbius loops and other weird bits of mathematics which vaguely link to this, I did a whole lecture about it for the Royal Institution. They have the video up on their channel. You can go and watch that. It has the Möbius loop and loads of other bits and pieces in there. If you're in need of more nerd romance on my maths gear site, this year we have a Valentine's card which has a heart made of parametric equations, the actual equations and all the coordinates for the dots are on the inside, and there you are, I chart you. If you're a mathematics teacher and you just want a copy of the equations that plot this and maybe a spreadsheet that you can use, in the description below I'll have a link to my Think Maths website, which is where I put my free teaching resources. You can download a spreadsheet, it has this all built in, and your students can mess around with the various parameters to plot their own maths heart shape.